think I'll start with sharing a little experience of what I've gone through in the industry from a professional to an entrepreneur today. I think when I stepped into this business, the first thing when I started working, the chairman of the quality ice cream company, Mr. P.L. Lamba, called me and he told me and gave me a golden mantra to this restaurant business. He said, good food. He said it in Punjabi, so I'll say it in Punjabi so that it is. He said, changi roti, te badiya service. You can never fail. Good food and good service, you could never fail in this business. Understanding today's environment, I think things have changed drastically. The business has become very dynamic. The restaurant business is, people are wanting to experiment. There are concept restaurants now. People are not scared to just not eat Indian or Chinese food. They want to experiment on other cuisines too. So I think the most important, when you talk of this aspect, eat or be eaten, is a very, very varied thing to talk of at this point of time. But if you look at the rudiments of the basic restaurant business, is good food, good service. It might appeal from a QSR concept to a mid-segment concept restaurant to a mass product restaurant or to a theme restaurant or a concept restaurant. And I think the basis of this business is good food, good service. And any business today is scalable. I understand the real estate cost is too much for this business to expand and grow as it should be growing. Because of the real estate cost, the P&Ls don't look very positive. The return of investment doesn't seem very rosy. But this business is growing. This business has potential. People still want to eat out. Gone are the days when people would venture out in the business for one day. They go out dining for one day. Today people want to go 7 days a week. They want to celebrate with their family, with their friends. That's how the trend of the business is changing. So I feel, whilst this business is very, very dynamic, it's a very lovely business to be in, but it's a very tricky business also. So I think the essence of this business is, besides your good food and quality, you need to be the differentiator. I think constant innovation in the restaurant business is very important. There are various ways of introducing new items. Like he said, you know, the specials of the day, or it could be a tent card menu where you're trying to push certain items in the restaurant. It could be a food festival. It could be some innovations which you would want to try to the consumers. And something you always want to add in the restaurant, because, you know, as a consumer, consumers also have a very staple feeling about a restaurant, that they, if they come and visit my restaurant, they would want to have a particular food because they've been used to it. So we always do our analysis. You know, we have systems, we have processes where we can find out which dishes are selling, which dishes are not selling, what items are doing well, what items are not doing well. Even if we are experimenting, normally I think he would agree to me that we don't do a complete changeover as far as the cuisine is concerned, until unless we are renovating the whole restaurant. You all the time invest on our manpower. I think that is the most important aspect of any success of any restaurant today. So I think right from the server level to the manager level, we need to fix KRAs for them, incentivize them. You know, off lately in my system, we had a lot of people who had worked for 10 years and they were not seeing growth, though they were happy. But you have to show them growth. Rather than what normally happens is we get a lot of people from outside and we don't understand and nurture the talent from inside sometimes. So what happens in the process is that the person down there gets very demotivated and he says, boss, chal hi raha hai, kya farak pad.